Anasazi flute has a lot of history. It is said to be a flute from around the year 624. It was discovered in a Pueblo apartment in a cliff dwelling of the Anasazi, underneath a stone found by a group of folks that were searching for pottery to sell to museums. And underneath this stone were two tied together with the rope created by the yucca plant. They had six holes, three and three, and it was a rim flute, which is very difficult to play. It's like the ney or the cabal. And so what I did was I took the Andean kena, or the kenacho way. I take a hot iron and I go this way and then up this way, and it makes a great place for air to split, giving it great sound. The thing to know is you have to lift upwards to make a good connection. You have to grin softly and create a line and then spit watermelon seeds gently. And then on the fingering, we discovered that if you keep the peace sign fingers together, the scale is a lot more melodic. And this last hole almost has a sense of yearning to it. It kind of reminds me of that all of a sudden the Anasazis disappeared and nobody really knows what happened to them. And when you hit that note, it kind of reminds me a little bit of the sadness and the mystery of these people. So when playing this flute, I recommend starting all closed, keeping these guys together, and going up and down the scale. About an octave and a half inside the Anasazi flute at ErikTheFluteMaker.com.